And now, the continuation of Hell's Kitchen.
That's the most terrifying experience of my life. I'm in disbelief right now, just how close I was to being eliminated. I promise you, it will not happen again.
We got faith in you, man.
I joke around a lot, but now things are gonna be a little different. It's no joke now.
Yo, we don't have an ashtray over here.
Oh, she's
Roche, bring me an ashtray, please. Please.
I'm blue now, man.
Oh, come on.
It was not my decision to go in the blue team, but whatever color it is, you know, red, white, blue, purple, I'm going to give my 110%.
Welcome to Team Blue.
And we're all fighters.
I'm a fighter.
While the men welcome their newest member to the blue team, the women...
She's always blaming everybody anyway.
Who?
She's like, Robin.
...are a team divided.
So going to go down with her, and so going to go down with Kimmy.
The red team has a big rift in it right now,
and we all... hate each other.
Daniel and Dana are gonna have each other's back as lovers, and Christina's starting to fight with them.
It's gonna start getting dirty.
After a rough dinner service and a small shakeup on the blue team,
Rush,
I don't like it.
Come on.
The chefs are more focused than ever, and that's good because Chef Ramsay,
let's go,
is not letting up.
Big day tonight. There's one cuisine that I have come to love in a big way. It's something that we've never focused on here in Hell's Kitchen ever before. That cuisine is Mexican.
Yeah.
Amazing.
I'm fired up. I love Mexican food. I cook Mexican food all the time. I eat Mexican food all the time. This is my strength. We're winning.
Scott, get your big ass in here. Let's go.
Wow.
That's a big donkey.
And that's a piñata. Wow.
I definitely want to take a whack at Chef Scott's ass.
So, for today's challenge, you'll be turning 5 Mexican classics into fine dining food. In a moment, these balls are going to be scattered everywhere. Each of them has a different ingredient on them. Listen carefully. Each team has 90 seconds to grab a maximum of 25 balls. And you split those ingredients to make 5 stunning dishes. On your marks. Get set. Go.
Oh, I did not expect 40 gazillion balls to fall from the ceiling and bounce all over the place.
Balls are literally everywhere.
20 seconds to go.
I got carnitas.
Oranges.
What about crema?
I got mushrooms.
Pineapple seed.
I knew there was a few specific balls that I need to get my hands on. So I got down on my knees and I just grabbed whatever balls were in front of me.
Garbanzo beans.
3.
Cucumber.
2.
Tomatillos.
1. And stop.
It was a lot of balls.
Line up. Okay. You have 35 minutes to make 5 stunning dishes. Everybody ready?
Yes, Chef.
Your time starts now. Off you go. Let's go.
Using the ingredients written on the balls they selected, each team must create fine dining versions of 5 traditional Mexican dishes.
I got burrito.
I'm taking enchilada.
I would like a soup.
I'm gonna do tacos.
Tacos. Anybody else wanna do tacos?
I'll do tacos.
I'll do tostada.
Everybody ready?
All 7 chefs will cook a dish, but each team must choose which 5 they will present to Chef Ramsay for judging.
What kind of tacos are you doing, Brian?
Shrimp with 2 sauces.
I know how to put together a beautiful Mexican plate. My dish is sexy. It's simple. It's beautiful. And it melts, and it's pure ecstasy. That's what I'm all about. I'm about simplicity and sex.
While Brian's in love with what he's cooking...
That was hot. I didn't know that.
...over in the red kitchen...
I mean, I don't really know how to make a burrito if I'm dining.
Danielle isn't warming up to her burrito.
I'm really worried about Danielle right now. I don't care if she had never worked with Mexican before. It's really not that hard.
I need something. I don't know what. This is my first time cooking Mexican ever. I'm nervous. I'm gonna give it 125%.
15 seconds to go.
Yes, Chef.
Is everybody plating?
Yes.
Now, start deciding which one you're serving and which one you're dropping.
In the red kitchen,
Yeah, that's good. What, this looks great.
The women quickly decide which dishes to present to Chef Ramsay.
All right, we're ready to rock and roll over here.
But over in the blue kitchen,
which dish are you dropping?
They're struggling to choose between Royce and Brian's tacos.
Pat, you gotta make a decision here.
And they've decided to give Patrick the final vote.
10 seconds left.
Which one tasted better?
Hurry up.
Guys, I'm going with Royce's.
Sit.
Yeah, kidding me, man.
It's a bad call.
Okay, for this challenge, I brought in two fantastic, amazing judges. First, we have the owner and the executive chef of the stunning restaurant, Ortega 120, Thomas Ortega. Thomas.
Hello.
Good to see you, sir.
Likewise.
How are you?
Good, very good.
Thank you so much for coming.
Thanks for having us.
Our next judge is the executive chef at Rivera and Player here in LA, John Sadler. John, thank you so much for joining us.
Thank you very
good
much.
Good to see you.
It feels really good to put your dish in front of like these big-time chefs. You want them to taste your food. When they say it's good, you know it's good.
Okay, let's start off. Tacos, let's go.
First up in the Mexican Fine Dining Challenge, Royce and Kimmy will go head-to-head.
Let's start off with Royce.
I thought traditional pork tacos. I also have a smoked pimentón potatoes.
The one thing that doesn't attract me is the greasiness of the tortilla.
I agree with Thomas.
Kimmy.
I made a shrimp fajita taco.
Why did you choose a flour tortilla over a corn tortilla?
I'm from Memphis, so we eat a lot of flour stuff.
The abundance of vegetables and the variety that you put on these tacos, they look very appetizing.
Mm-hmm. I mean, the flavors are very strong. I'm gonna have to go with the red team on this one.
Red team? John?
I agree, red team.
My tacos were beautiful, vibrant, fresh. As certain as this is my right hand, Kimmy would not have beaten me.
Next up, the burritos, please. Let's go.
Let's go, Clemenza, man.
Danielle, please explain the dish to our guests.
I went with the New York strip. I grilled that.
It's kind of falling apart.
Do you roll it tightly?
It's a little hard to eat.
Clemenza, please present the dish.
We have kind of a Mexican-Italian burrito. I got the two cheeses, provolone and mozzarella, with a pork and chicken, and just kind of tried to make everything work together.
I've always found that Mexican food and Italian food are compadres. That's a great idea.
Thank you.
I like that you thought out of the box. I'm going to go with the blue team on this one.
John.
I agree, blue team.
Excellent. Good job, Clemenza.
Thank you, sir. It was a fantastic feeling. I wanted to pull down my pants and sit across the floor in my underwear like Risky Business.
Yeah!
Thank you.
The soup, please.
With the teams tied at one, Tiffany's crab salsa soup.
It tastes good. We get the delicious flavor of the crab.
Is up against Justin's pickled shrimp tortilla soup.
I actually overall like the flavor of that.
Mm, thank you, Chef.
And although both dishes impress,
I have to say that the red team did it for me.
I agree. Definitely.
Thank you.
Tiffany gets the point, putting the women up by one.
Okay, next up. Enchilada, please. Let's go.
Christina's fine dining take on carnitas enchiladas.
I feel that that dish has been sanitized of anything Mexican.
Takes a hit.
Lacking the authenticity.
While Patrick's lobster enchilada.
Flavor is so good and had the spirit of Mexico.
Packs a punch.
Red team or blue team?
Blue team.
I'm going to have to go with the blue team.
Blue team. Congratulations. Good job, Patrick. Okay, tied up. 2-2. Last dish is the round of the tostada. Let's go. Come on, Roshni.
Yeah, we got a shot to actually win this. I'm stoked. We're tied up. Roshni's up against the former team. Wouldn't it be something if Roshni were to pull off the win for the blue team?
Okay, Dana.
I did a seared ahi tuna tostada.
Nice idea, the watermelon and the mango.
Thank you, Chef.
I like the way the tuna went with the little bite of the jicama, the watermelon.
Come on, Dana. We can pull this point off and we can win this. Let's do this.
Good job.
Thank you, Chef.
Pretty good. Roshni, please present your dish.
I went with a grilled tostada with a chili crab filling. I brought my roots into a little bit. I roasted off coriander seed first.
Thomas, what do you think?
I love the flavor of the coriander and the spice at the back of the end. It's very nice.
Thank you, Chef.
I'm gonna have to go with the blue team.
Blue team.
I really like that vibrant flavor in my mouth.
The salsa is the best salsa that I had here today.
Thank you, Chef.
but the Red Team created the best overall fresh dish.
Red Team. Wow. Two very well thought out dishes.
Oh, now we're at a draw. What happens now?
Gents, we're faced with a tough decision.
It's the final round of Hell's Kitchen's first ever Mexican Fine Dining Challenge.
I'm gonna have to go with the blue team.
John, it's all down to you.
The red team.
And the guest judges have come to a draw.
We're faced with a tough decision. Well done.
Thank you,
Chef. Both back in line.
Now, it's up to Chef Ramsay to break the tie between Dana and her former teammate, Roshni.
Oh, come on, come on, come on.
I'm staring at Chef Ramsay, trying to use the Jedi powers of blue, 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 blue. Blue, 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 blue.
Congratulations. Red team.
Yeah! I won for our team, and it feels so, 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 so good.
That dish was the best overall dish of the day.
Thank you, chefs. Thank you.
What's up? Who's the best on the red team?
Thomas, thank you so much. John,
thank you,
best wishes. Thank you so much. Well
thank
done.
You very much.
Brilliant. Ladies, as your reward, you're all going to have an amazing day inspired by Mexican culture.
Yeah.
We're going to head off to John Sadler's restaurant, Rivera, for a stunning gourmet lunch.
Yeah.
And there is a big surprise waiting for you there.
Where is it?
Don't get changed because your limo is waiting. Off you go. Good job. Blue team, you'll be having a day of Mexican misery. It's Mexican night. You'll be prepping all the salsas by hand, all the tortillas. Off you go.
I was robbed of my chance to bounce back from my performance last night. With my dish there, we would have won.
Brian wants redemption, so I'm sure he's a little perturbed at me. You know, whatever.
This is what happens when you lose, Roshni. Welcome to losing.
While Roshni officially becomes a loser on the blue team, the red team gets ready to enjoy their victory.
Go get intoxicated. Woo, woo, woo. Hi, guys. Bye.
Bye.
We got a wet bar.
Hey.
Welcome to Rivera.
Thank you.
I am definitely excited to be eating in style today.
Oh my God.
And what you have is the classic Yucatan puerco pibil.
This is so good.
Sure. So good.
Perfect, right?
I love Mexican food. Oh, the sous vide pork was so good.
I love to experience food.
This is honestly the best pizza.
It was like the best meal I've ever had in my entire life. It was that good.
To the red team!
So where is the blue team right now?
Here we go, guys.
Tripe.
Oh, I like tripe.
My joke when I eat tripe is I say it tastes like grass.
It's gonna taste like ass.
I'm about to throw up before we even started.
That's disgusting.
I don't like tripe. It's got an awful, awful, awful smell. It's this musky, nasty, dead Just keep that away from me. I hate tripe.
Ugh. Gonna barf on the table.
I'm telling you, a little lemon, I'd be golden.
Oh my God, are you serious?
Oh, wow.
Hey, guys. Why don't you come up? Let's all learn some salsa. Come on.
Oh, salsa dancing. I'm kind of scared.
1, 2, 3, do the side. 1, 5.
I don't know how to dance. I'm from the South. We bounce in the South. We don't do this little slow stuff. I mean, we get down in the South.
1, 2, the back. 1, 3, to the sides.
Like
1, 2, 3, yes, to the side.
While the red team is cutting loose, the blue team is just cutting. And cutting. And cutting.
Patrick, you done with this over here? This is me, Patrick. I keep talking to you a lot of times and you just still not answer me. Patrick, if you're gonna take the lead, lead.
I'm trying to figure something out.
Then you wanna come over and buff out and expect me to listen.
You can do whatever you want. Honestly, you can do whatever you want.
That's like the 10th
Help
time.
Me.
It's like
I've got everybody asking
like
questions
every
I'm trying to
time.
Get the rest.
I get that. Now you
hit me.
I'm not gonna lead everybody to the promised land. If you need me to tell you to go prep some, you should even be here.
Fabulous.
Tequila was excellent.
Not winning is like pulling your lips to the back of your head while someone throws dripping acid on your face. It sucks.
After a long punishment, the blue team finally gets a chance to unwind.
They don't even use flour tortillas in Mexico.
But someone is still bitter about the challenge.
Unless your girl from Memphis is not gonna make a better flavored taco than me. Especially when you're going into a taco challenge that's supposed to be somewhat traditional, you don't use flour tortillas.
I don't wanna listen to anybody bitch. No bitching. I'm on a no bitching policy now.
Despite her no bitching policy, after drinking it over, Tiffany makes it her duty to fill in Kimmy and Robin on the gossip.
So what are our lovely ladies have to say this evening, Tiff?
There's a lot said. Dana and Christina and Danielle said something like...
The problem is...
They don't even use flour tortillas in Mexico.
In her current state, she somehow decides what Royce said was actually said by three members of her own team.
They just, I mean, basically it was like the whole like, oh, she's from the South, and why was she using flour tortillas type of like.
I got the point though, right?
Exactly.
Dana, Danielle, and Christina are all talking behind my back. I don't understand where all those girls' heads are at. I didn't see Christina pull a point. Didn't see Danny pull a point.
It's the start of a new day, and before the red team heads down to the kitchen to prep.
Please, can we just squash whatever's going on out?
I don't have a problem with anybody.
Robin is determined to clear the air.
I heard that people were talking about Kimmy's dish.
About her dish?
Something like that.
No.
So
nobody talked about her dish. I was not down there for any.
All right, someone's lying then. This is all he said, she said. Let's get it out on the open table and discuss it.
I think all three of y'all are pieces of for talking about me about last night at the jacuzzi.
Can you tell me when you heard this?
Yeah, tell me what we said.
Okay, so you didn't say that I should have made corn tortillas instead of flour.
I said nothing about your dish. You heard somebody say something and now you're coming at us.
Just telling you what was said to me, man.
You're making assumptions and you're mad at us
and
we don't know why. That's not really fair.
You are because you weren't there and you didn't hear it.
If you don't quit interrupting me and screaming over me, Dana, you can kiss my ass. You're a bitch. Where I come from, that's how I
you come up to call me.
Damn right I call. Yeah, you damn right.
I don't give a about your tacos. You could tell me how ghetto you are from Memphis, like, do what you want. Come hit me if you want. I said nothing about your dish.
You're a bitch.
Tonight is the first ever Mexican night in Hell's Kitchen. But right now, a misunderstanding on the red team caused by Tiffany.
I said nothing about your dish.
Has the women at each other's throats.
I don't need to apologize for. I didn't do anything. You came at me, and now
and
we
I'm
have
always
a problem.
Gonna feel like so. That, so get used to it.
I'm not gonna get used to it. I'm just not gonna talk to you. I'll talk to you in the kitchen when I have to talk to you, and that's it.
She's a child. I'm still pissed. They're all lying bitches. I don't trust any of them. I just don't know if fighting right before service was a good idea.
You need me to move?
While the women have lost all common courtesy in the blue kitchen, everyone is on their best behavior.
The fact that Roshni is in the kitchen with us, we're holding back on the cursing and the yelling. Don't use that word, man. That ain't cool.
Sorry.
You know, there's a woman present. You don't want to be disrespectful, so we're all better guys with her on our team.
Bless you.
Thank you.
Ladies, let's go. Let's go, guys. Line up, please. Let's go. Okay, tonight we're making history. Why? Because it's our first ever Mexican night. I'm so excited, aren't you guys?
Yes, Chef!
Thank you. Get on your station. Let's go. James, what the f- are you wearing?
Chef!
Honestly. I'd rather give a wave than wear that. Open Hell's Kitchen, please.
Yes,
let's go.
Sí, señor.
Ah!
Fine Dining Mexican Night, Chef Ramsay has created a special menu featuring an ahi tuna tostada, tequila cilantro mussels, and a New York strip with mojo verde.
Order in, Chef.
Ladies, let's go. Four covers, table 30. Two tuna, two mussels.
Yes, Chef.
It's really important to start off strong. The apps have to come right out the gate and take the lead. I'm hoping Barbie can pull it out.
How long for the mussels?
Walking with mussels, Chef.
One's full of flavor here, and one's totally abandoned and abused. Even the color's different. Bland, delicious, unbelievable. Can somebody help Barbie, please?
You got it? I'll back off if you got it.
It's right here. I got it.
I had some trouble starting off, but I'm gonna fight back. I can do this.
While the red team starts over on their first ticket.
Come on, we can't get behind.
Back in the blue kitchen.
Let's go. Two tuna.
Guy is ready to impress with his first appetizers.
Walking with tuna.
Walking with the tuna.
I know my I will not, under any circumstances, put out bad food. That's it.
Oh, my God. Yes, come sir. Here. I've got one warm and one touch that. Stone cold.
It's good. It's good.
You want to argue? I want it at room temperature. Look at me. Just do it. I don't want tuna tasting of the fridge. Got it?
Yes, chef. Firing another two right now.
The tuna? I mean, come on, your pan's tearing a piece of tuna, guy. Get it right.
Tuna!
Coming up, chef!
Tuna!
Tuna, to the
best. Where's tuna? Finally. Service, please.
Thank you.
Guy's tuna has garnered Chef Ramsay's stamp of approval.
Walking with the Rams.
Service, please.
And appetizers are quickly leaving the blue kitchen.
Yours good?
Very good.
Now Barbie is ready.
Walking with muscles, Chef.
To get her vote of confidence from Chef Ramsay with her second attempt at the first appetizers.
Service, please.
A half hour into dinner service, Barbie has bounced back, and her muscles are making their way out to the dining room.
They're perfect.
Coming right back with the garnish.
Service, please.
With appetizers now steadily leaving the kitchen.
Two snapper, two New York strip, two chicken, two pork.
Danielle on meat.
We're coming, chef, in about 30 seconds with the pork.
And Dana and Kimmy are ready to move on to entrees.
Are you putting this all on one thing?
Yep.
Oh, hey. Fish and meat on the same tray. Meat dripping into the fish. Fish dripping into the meat.
I said to her, where do you want me to put this? Do you want it on this tray? And she's like, yeah, sure, put it on that tray.
Who put that on there? That's disgusting. Who done that?
I'm waiting on Dana to say she did it because that bitch did it.
How can you put that onto one tray?
I think Kimmy needs to grow some balls. It's your station, man up.
Who put that on there? Was it a ghost? Somebody tell me what is happening. Idiots.
An hour into Hell's Kitchen's first ever Mexican night.
Hey,
Chef Ramsay has made a disappointing discovery.
Fish and meat on the same tray. Meat dripping into the fish, fish dripping into the meat.
But no one on the red team will admit to the crime.
Who put that on there? Who put that on there? Who?
I did, Chef. Dana put that on there. I said I did it to Chef Ramsay because it was my station, but it was her fault.
Go ahead.
I got it, move. I got it,
okay.
I got it, move. Get off my station.
So now we're dragging the New York strip.
I was pissed that I'm getting in trouble for something somebody else did.
You know I didn't put that on there, right?
Yeah. All right, just check.
Dana, did you put that on there?
Nope, I asked her
salt.
Specifically. Do
no,
you want
I
to
salt.
Put it on there?
No,
care if you finish the food, shut up. I want to hear it, stop.
Stay over there and off my nasty bitch, dude.
Kimmy, like, for a big girl, is a big baby. That's what she is. You know, I don't need to deal with that if I'm trying to help you. That's
dude, I was totally sorry for that bitch came
out. All right, we'll discuss it later. Let's bounce back.
Boss to the wall.
While Kimmy stews in the red kitchen, over in the blue kitchen.
Entree, one chicken, one pork, one New York strip. How long?
1.5 minutes, chef.
Patrick and Guy are ready with their first entrees.
Chicken's I'm going to the pass
up.
With the
going
chicken.
The chicken.
You have the New York strip.
Going up to the pass, three strips.
Unbelievable. Stop! One just slightly overcooked, and one that is dry. Come on, talk to me, guy.
Come on, guy, get it right. I know you can cook a steak. We've all done this a million times before. Is that rocket science?
Patrick!
Yes, chef.
He's given up. He's stopped. He's off. He's switched off. But you need to control it. You're going to start showing up now.
Yes, chef.
I guess his expectation for me is a lot higher than everybody else. And that's fine. I'm always willing to step up and take the lead.
All right, brother. Hold it tight. You got
no
it.
No problem.
While Patrick gets Guy going on the grill, back in the red kitchen, Danielle.
Yo, my pork is like the bomb, yo. Who said Danny can't grill?
Is confident that they're now ready with their first entrees.
Okay, I'm ready.
Walking now, chef.
I'm feeling confident. The pork is perfect. You know, this is my time to shine.
Chef, one pork.
Let's go. Come on, let's go. Me. All of you.
Yes, chef.
Stop. Yeah, come here. The ultimate insult. Raw pork. Not pink. Not slightly undercooked. Stop!
He was pissed. I felt really bad for the pig. The pig didn't do it. It was Danielle.
Sorry, chef.
Oh, Danielle.
You got two more in the oven?
Yeah.
Two more in the oven and drop two more. Sear two more. We gotta do that whole check again.
While Danielle starts over on her pork in the blue kitchen.
I'm starting to cut. You ready?
Hurry,
yes, I am.
Guy and Patrick are ready to have their entrees blessed by Chef Ramsay.
Guys, I'm going to the pass.
I'm walking to the pass.
Yeah.
Well, almost ready.
Two chicken, how long?
I have a chicken in the oven. It'll be one more minute, Chef. I'm very sorry. I'm working on it.
Yeah, I'll from you. Piss off.
Sorry, Chef.
Have you sliced the strip?
Yeah, I did.
You let him slice, and your chicken's one more minute. Piss off! What are you gonna do? You shouldn't have sliced it.
Patrick, you told me to cut the steak. You didn't give me the right time. You told me it's ready, and it wasn't ready.
You.
Come here, you two.
The chef.
Hey, piss off.
I've never been thrown out of anything in my life, so it's a bad place to be, and it's a feeling.
So whatever.
I up a chicken, I up the table.
With Patrick and Guy banished to the dorms,
two pork, two chicken, guys.
The remaining members of the blue team try to come together on the entrees.
We can do this, baby. Let's just pull this off.
And in the red kitchen,
where's the pork?
Right here.
Danielle is looking to redeem herself with her second attempt at the pork.
I think it's good. If it's not, I'm gonna freak out.
Oh, Danielle, he's cutting it, so just get another one going. Because that can't hot
back.
Right now,
it's
Danielle.
Coming back.
It's raw. Danny, get another pork working now. Now.
Hey, just stop! Raw pork again, pink and bloody in the middle. I give up. And one more thing, get out!
Danielle sent out raw pork, and she didn't send it out once, but twice. She sent up raw pork.
Christina, flash that pork on that griddle pan, urgently.
Yes, chef.
An hour and 15 minutes into dinner service, three chefs have been kicked out of the kitchen.
Getting hungry, huh, baby?
I know.
No entrees have been served.
One chicken, one pork, one New York strip, how long?
And Chef Ramsay's patience is understandably wearing thin.
New York is walking.
I'm going up with pork, two chicken, guys.
Where's the pork?
One more pork, how long?
None of them are cooked. Two more minutes on the pork.
Oh,
talk
come
about
on.
This is ready right here.
Justin, don't put out the pork. Don't put out the pork. It's not cooked.
Ready right here. Here. Sorry, chef. I apologize.
Sure that was done? Don't put out the pork. It's not cooked. Don't put out the pork. It's not cooked. Don't put out the pork. It's not cooked.
Hey, both of you, come here.
Set the pork. Done.
That is it. Get out.
Yes, chef. I said it wasn't done.
Can I please?
Get out!
I just told you the pork's not cooked five times.
It's my fault, Mezzo.
How dumb can you be?
The total number of chefs in the dorms is now up to five. And in the red kitchen, Barbie is taking special precautions to make sure she doesn't join them.
Are you, come here, you.
Yes, sir. That?
Today we need, look at me, a thermometer. The day we need that to cook a breast of chicken. You get out!
I don't know why she can't cook chicken. I really don't. Cooking a breast of chicken is about as easy as taking a Anybody can do it. Are you that dumb?
Tiffany,
yes,
put
chef.
That down. Look at me.
Yes,
seriously,
chef.
I've had enough. Burnt mash. Get out. Get out. I swear to God, I don't give a if the whole team goes home tonight. I don't care.
Chef Ramsay is on like a kicking out spree tonight.
I'm kind of scared right now. I'm not going to lie.
It's the four of us now. Let's get this done. Let's go.
90 minutes into dinner service, and tonight is on its way to being the worst dinner service since opening night.
Got out one person that makes one more up on that table. Where's the chicken?
It's up.
And Chef Ramsay is ready to snap.
Hey, Chef. Chef, come here. Burnt bits of crispy skin. Sorry. Eat that. How did that taste?
Terrible, Chef.
Get out! Hey, I'm done. You're over your head. Get out of here.
All of a sudden, me and Roche, holy
I don't give a if I finish this table on my own with Scott. I don't care anymore.
We are screwed big time.
Both of you, come here.
It's more than 2 hours into Mexican night.
Hey, piss off.
And so far, Chef Ramsay has said adios to 8 chefs.
Get out of here.
And the last 2 members of the blue team may be about to join them.
Both of you, come in. I swear to God, on my children's life, you that table, that's it.
Yes,
it's
chef.
History.
Yes, chef.
It's history.
I look at Brian looks at me, I said, come on, Brian, we'll push this out. How's it looking, Brian?
Beautiful.
You ready?
I'm ready.
Let's go.
Sauce is up.
2 chicken.
Service, please.
While Brian and Roshni...
I'm walking with the garnish.
Walking with the wrap.
...managed to rise from the rubble in the blue kitchen, the remaining chefs on the red team...
Come on, ladies, let's do this.
...are also coming together to get their food out.
Chicken walking through the window. Walking through the window on mushrooms.
Service, please.
And both teams complete dinner service.
Good job, Roche.
Brian, you too.
Being one of the last 2 people in the kitchen tonight...
Ooh, God, that feels good.
Tonight turned out to be an absolute disgrace. Raw pork. Kimmy.
Yes, chef.
Honestly, New York strip, touching snapper on the same tray.
Dana was the one that put the steak on with the fish.
Is that true, Dana?
That is not how I recall it happening. Are you putting this all on one thing?
Yep.
I asked her if she was using the same tray, and the answer was yes. So if I put it on there, then I did under her direction. That's what I remember happening.
Patrick, as the oldest person in this kitchen, are you tired?
No, chef, I'm not tired.
I'm tired of you. I don't get it. Both teams lose. Let's get that right. We should be embarrassed. Both teams, get upstairs and come up with 2 individuals for elimination.
Yes, chef.
I'm out of it. Leave me alone, will you?
This was not a hard service. We should be mortified. All of us. Everybody on this team needs to be held accountable.
We have to obviously pick somebody.
The 2 stations that really went down and then people had to really help, and the initial people on them should be what it is. So I feel Patrick and Guy.
Based on tonight, I have to go with the same. Patrick and Guy.
I think it's a strategic move on their part to put me up now.
I'm a man amongst boys, and they're vultures waiting to feast on my carcass, and I'm gonna bring the biggest fight they've ever seen.
While Patrick prepares for battle on the red team, the gloves are already off.
You f***ed us on the tuna with that mussels.
Well, you know what? I got kicked out for sticking a thermometer in a piece of chicken.
No, you didn't, bitch. Yo, no bitch words. No, no, it's gonna go down. You know how I talk.
Barbie is the weakest link on the red team, period. If this was the hood, this bitch would already be beat the f*** down right now.
I think Kimmy, like, blew it, and she didn't try to make it right at all.
I'm not putting myself up. No. Hell no. Because I don't feel like I deserve to be up there.
Q
Kimmy, she deserves to be up there. I think Kimmy should go home.
Listen, this is how I feel. Common sense is her. It's because she served Raw Park.
I know, but it's not like I was up all night. That was the first thing. I don't think I up royally. I just sent out a raw pork.
I just feel like
Danielle doesn't deserve to go home tonight based on her performance.
It's close between Danny, Barbie, and Kimmy. I think I need to talk to Christina right now because Danielle is my best friend here and I don't want her to go home.
Kimmy, Robin, and Tiffany have a alliance. I feel like the three of us need to stick together because if we don't, they're gonna pick us off one by one. But if you don't vote for her, I think she might not go up.
Talking to Dana, she brought up a lot of really good points, but Danny had the pork come back twice. I don't want to see Danny go home, and Kimmy really was a earlier in the day. I don't know.
Mexican night. It was a massacre. Lorenza, first nominee, and why?
First nominee was Pat. Just didn't think the communication was there. I think he broke down a little bit.
Never.
Second nominee, and why?
Blue team nominated Guy. He made a few mistakes. He put some things out wrong that kind of screwed us.
Barbie, first nominee, and why?
The red team's first nominee tonight was me, Chef, because I was weeded on the Hot App station.
Second nominee.
Red team's second nominee tonight.
After a dinner service that finished with more chefs in the dorms than in the kitchen, the blue team has nominated Guy and Patrick. The red team has nominated Barbie and now must give their second nominee.
Red team's second nominee tonight was Danny, Chef, because she served the raw pork and just couldn't seem to get herself together.
Okay, Guy, Patrick, Barbie, Danielle, step forward. Let's go. Patrick.
Chef.
Why do you think you should stay in Hell's Kitchen?
I've been consistent, professional. Tonight I made a poor decision on the chicken. It was the mistake I made tonight. I own up to that, but I never make the same mistake again.
You're beat, aren't you?
I am not beat, Chef. Nowhere near beat.
Guy.
Yes, Chef.
Why should you stay in Hell's Kitchen?
First of all, I've been solid so far about everything. I've never lowered my standards for nothing, and I'm definitely a fighter.
Are you in over your head?
Nah. I can look you in the eyes and tell you, I'm not over my head.
Danielle, back again.
Yes.
Why do you think you should stay in Hell's Kitchen?
I put myself on the station that I've never worked because I want to be here. I want to stand out. But yes, I messed up a pork chop, and I'll probably never do that again.
Barbie.
Yes, Chef.
Why do you think you should stay in Hell's Kitchen?
I don't feel like I deserve to be up here, Chef. I don't feel like I'm the weakest chef, so I don't feel like I deserve to be here.
Do you know what? You're right. Back in line. This is tough, this one. The person leaving Hell's Kitchen is...